So today I'm going to show you an experiment talking about water vapor pressure and how water could boil at a much lower temperature. In fact, when you pour cold water on hot water, and you know, I will show that the water starts boiling. So here is a water bottle that I have some hot water, and on the top of this water bottle you have some water vapor, and water vapor is there, and almost no air, it's all water vapor. It's a low pressure water vapor which is there, and hot water is here. It's not too hot, but yes, it is almost like close to 80 degrees centigrade or something. Okay, so now I have this flask filled with ice cold water. And if you see closely, when I start pouring this water on this top of this water bottle, then the water vapor in this bottle will condensate and it will start boiling the water which is there in this bottle. So now you can see the water is boiling. The water which is there inside the bottle is boiling because I have poured the cold water on top. The water vapor has condensated and it has reduced the pressure or water vapor on the top. So when water vapor temperature reduces, water vapor pressure reduces, this water starts boiling. The reason is that water has a vapor pressure which only depends on temperature, and as the temperature increases, the vapor pressure increases. And when the vapor pressure of water reaches the pressure on the top of the water, then water starts boiling. So when the temperature reaches 100 degrees centigrade, the vapor pressure becomes 1 atmospheric pressure. And that's why water boils at 1 atmospheric pressure and 100 degrees centigrade. If you increase the pressure more than 1 atmospheric pressure, which we do it in a pressure cooker, then water boils at a much higher temperature, which helps the food to be cooked sooner. And that's the purpose of pressure cooker. Now, similarly, when you reduce the pressure, the water could boil at a much lower temperature. This is what I'm going to show it again. So when I pour cold water on this, then what happens is the water vapor which is there at the top of this bottle, that condensates and reduces the pressure. And therefore, the water is able to boil at a much lower temperature. You can see the water is boiling because the pressure on this water has reduced. The water vapor which is there on the top of this bottle had condensated and it has reduced the pressure. Since the pressure reduced, the water can boil at a much lower temperature. See it again. As I pour more cold water, this water vapor pressure reduces at the top and the water starts boiling. You see this? This is the experiment that I wanted to show you. Don't do this experiment in your house. You are too young to handle this hot water and you may get burnt. I will explain more in the class today. But this is what I wanted to show you, that water has vapor pressure and water boils when the vapor pressure equals the pressure on the top of the water surface. I will explain further in the class. Thank you.